Hi everybody, welcome back to the channel. Today I am going to talk about a Chinese pen. You know, I am not really very big fan of Chinese pens, but this is one Chinese pen that I cannot put down. I have reviewed a few Chinese pens earlier also on my channel, and I do not, you know, vouch for them much, but this is one pen that, you know, has a lot of attention, you know, my attention, and I am not able to put this pen down actually. So this is Chinese, you know, Jinhao pen, Jinhao X450. So it has Jinhao, you also have Jinhao 750, X750, but this is the smaller version, X450. And this pen is way, way better than X750, I would say. So I will talk about the pen parts and then we will have a small writing sample. So this pen is from Jinhao, and this is a pen that comes in many colors. You know, you can find it in with silver trims, gold trims, black, blue, green, all types of colors are available for this pen. So this clip is okay, a little bit tight, but that's fine. So I have this pen in red because I did not have any red pens. So I got this in red. So this is a quite heavy pen. Both, you know, the cap and the body are of metal. They are all metallic, and you can see some kind of, you know, they have fortified this barrel of this pen with some kind of springs within this whole, you know, barrel. Since this is a metal pen, this pen cannot be used as a eyedropper pen. Do not put ink into this. So this pen just takes a standard cartridge or a converter, and you know, it works well. The grip section is plastic. So this nib is probably number 5, or no, it is around number 35 nib almost, but I'm not sure because this particular model is a older model. I have, you know, had this pen for around now probably 6 or 7 years, but I have not used this pen much. So this grip section has 3 notches to, you know, assist to the grip, and then the feed is plastic. So I'm not very great fan of these notches because they tend to, you know, disturb me while writing. So this is a downside on this pen for me. Otherwise this pen is okay. So the cap is, you know, push close cap, and the problem, there is one little more problem with this pen, is that when you close this pen, so this creates a kind of vacuum in this cap, and when you open this pen, the ink gets splattered inside the cap. You will be able to see here some, you know, ink inside the cap. So you might need to clean the cap from inside, you know, time and again. Otherwise there is no problem with this pen. So this is a small pen, which is not a very big pen. So if I compare this with my regular Parker, it's almost the size of the Parker. And when I uncap it, it is smaller than Parker, almost the size of Parker, I would say. It's a fat pen, not a thin pen. Okay, so let's have a small writing sample. Okay, so I am again using my 100 GSM paper. So pen is Jinhao X450 in, I think it is ruby red. And ink is Pilot, standard ink, not the Iroshizuku or other inks. This is standard ink, Pilot Black. Okay, let's write something. There is always something to be thankful of. So be thankful. So again, Chinese pens have been, you know, around for long, and somehow they write well. I don't know. Some pens do have issues. They do copy the pens. They create identical copies of the pen. But this pen is, you know, a pen that is quite popular among the pen, you know, fountain pen community. And then this writes also very well. You can write as fast as you want with this pen. This will not skip. These are my problems. This will not skip. And the price of these pens is very, very attractive. So these pens range around from, you know, 450 rupees to 500 rupees, Indian rupees. So within this price range, these pens tend to be, you know, very attractive. But within this price range, you will be able to get Indian pens also. So this pen is a cartridge converter pen, so it does not hold large amount of ink. But if you want a pen that holds large amount of ink, you can go for, you know, airmail quality pens. You will be able to get airmail quality pens for around 500. Even you will be able to get Parker pens for around 500 or 600 rupees. So there are other, you know, good quality pens as compared to the Chinese pens in the market. Because over time, the gold frames and this, you know, black lacquer will wear out. So if you want a pen that will last you for longer period of time, then probably you might not want to go for these Chinese pens. But for fun, if you want to write and, you know, write for some few years and then, you know, probably don't care about the pens, then these Chinese pens are good for experimentation, writing, you know, carrying these pens around everywhere. They won't disappoint you. Hope this video helps, and thanks for watching the video. Please do like the video, share the video, and subscribe to the channel. Thank you. Bye bye.